Hi everyone, welcome on the Voice of Reformation. We greet you all in the name of Jesus. May God be with you and bless you. I am Andreas, and we are going to be together on our today's lesson. The topic we have today is the effect of consumption of sugar. Before we proceed, let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this moment. We thank you because all of us, we're still under your protection. May your name be praised. For this time, we invite you to come and be with us and explain your holy word in our mind and lead all of us into the right way toward heaven and toward heaven. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Welcome back again, our brothers and sisters. Our today's lesson is the effect of the continue. Now the body is not for fornication, but for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. Also, when we read in the book of Ministry of Healing, chapter 125, this book says, our artificial civilization is encouraging evils destructive of sound principles. Customs and fashion are at war with the nature. The practices they enjoy and the indulgences they foster are steadily lessening both physical and mental strength and bringing upon the race an intolerable burden. Intemperance and crime, diseases and wretchedness are everywhere. Many transgress the laws of health through ignorance, as they need instruction. But the greater number know better than they do. They need to be impressed with the importance of making their knowledge a guide of life. The physician has many opportunities both of imparting a knowledge of health principles and showing the importance of putting them in practice. By right instruction, he can do much to correct evils that are working untold harm. Also in this book, on page 226, this book says, 227, many people bring diseases upon themselves by their self-indulgence. They have not lived in accordance with the natural law or the principles of strict purity. Others have disregarded the laws of health in their habit of eating, drinking, dressing, or working, and often Some form of vice is the cause of the feebleness of mind or body. So, this book tells us that many people bring diseases upon themselves by their self-indulgence, and they didn't live according with the natural laws or principles of strict purity. They disregarded the laws of health in their habit of eating, drinking, dressing, and working. For the effect of sugar consumption, the first one is that the sugar can cause weight gain. Consuming fructose increases your hunger and desire for food more than glucose. And additionally, excessive fructose consumption may cause a resistance to leptin, an important hormone that regulates hunger and tells your body to stop eating. For number two, sugar may increase your risk of heart diseases. A study in over 30,000 people found that those who consumed 17 to 21% of calories from added sugar had a 38% greater risk of dying from heart diseases compared to those consuming only 8% of calories from added sugar. For number three, sugar has been linked to acne. For number four, sugar increases your risk of diabetes. For number five, may increase your risk of cancer. For number six, may increase your risk of depression. For number seven, may accelerate the skin aging process to have a wrinkles and others. For number eight, sugar can increase cellular aging. For number nine, sugar drain your energy. Sugar drains your energy. For number 10, sugar can lead to fatty liver. Number 11, sugar increases kidney diseases risk. Having consistently high blood sugar levels can cause damage to the delicate blood vessels in your kidneys. These can lead to increased risk of kidney diseases. For number 12, sugar have negative impact to the dental health. Eating too much sugar can cause cavities. Bacteria in your mouth feed on sugar and release acid, which is byproduct, which cause tooth demineralization. For number 13, sugar increase the risk of developing gout. For number 14, sugar accelerate cognitive decline. So, high sugar diet can lead to impaired memory and have been linked to an increasing risk of dementia. Brothers and sisters, we need to be careful on the sugar consumption. When we read in the book of 3rd Epistle of John, chapter 1 on verse 12, verse 2, Bible says, "Beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health. Be in health, even as thy soul prospered. Beloved, we wish you above all things that thou may be prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospered. We greet you all the best, and God bless you in the name of Jesus. Amen.